sense, photographs always surprise us. The more you look at them, the more you discover new elements, and the more you make new connections to what you see. And in that way, that is also the strength and power of the photographs by Torbjörn Rødland, the fact that it keeps us in the process of continuously looking and trying to unravel and uncover the different layers and messages that are hidden behind his practice.
In the title, The Touch That Made You, there's different types of touch that it can refer to. The tactile qualities of the photographs, that's something that I'm continuously drawn to, but also the acknowledging the importance of touch between humans and animals, which is also a theme that reoccurs in the photographs, and also objects or materials touching each other. So when I combine oranges with hair, it's not to make a random combination of things, but I'm looking for a way for it to make sense photographically, for it to make sense emotionally for the viewer. And you have to come to the photograph with your own experiences, your own memories, photographic memories, to make sense of it.
This exhibition was in London at the Serpentine. It's now here at the Osservatorio at the Fondazione Prada. So we see the pictures again. They're like, you know, old friends whom we see again, but we look at them again differently. It's each time, you know, different. And I think it has to do with this almost oxymoronic quality Torbjörn has between sort of movement and standstill. It's almost like a dynamic standstill he creates, because of course these images are very staged. He stages them in his studio. They are not snapshots. Here, walls were built, so it was a display which was invented for the show in very close dialogue with the artist and the Serpentine, and of course the Osservatorio and the Fondazione Prada. And it's interesting that in these very intimate spaces, this sort of physical tactility of the image is even stronger in a way than in the London show. Many films he made over the years. These films often have a soundtrack, and they also elaborate on his, you know, relationship to music. And that we can show here three of his films. And of course, with the films, it's similar to his photographs. So we are always captured to return. You always see a different film each time he returns. These are not films you see in a linear fashion, you know, from A to B to C. These are films you can start wherever you want, and you will always see something else. So it is really an exhibition where we invite visitors, you know, to spend time and come back again and again.